The United States military deals with a lot of espionage and information warfare. We only know a fraction of what goes on, but a good read is the Mueller report. The Russian government was not only funding, you know, Facebook ads, but they had active assets on the ground. They do this through a lot of ways, and they've been here for a long time. This is nothing new. They are able to co-opt people's personal beliefs for their own. They expand on anti-government militias. They, you know, spread the flat earther, QAnon, BS. They do a lot of bad acting. And their goal is to cause division and distrust of the United States government. And Trump is an active asset of theirs. That's why Putin, you know, put so much effort, and he's gotten a lot of reward. An example of this would be Trump withholding military aid to Ukraine. While this happened, Russia ran a blitzkrieg that killed dozens of their officers. Another thing that Trump has done for the benefit of Russia is lift sanctions on them. It was actually vetoed by the Republicans, but he overrid the veto. It takes like 2/3 of the Senate to override a presidential veto, and they weren't able to do that. We have him at Helsinki, bashing the FBI, bowing to Putin, and again blaming Ukraine, making Putin's enemies his own, and trying to make it his cult's enemies as well. If you notice, he tries to tie Hunter Biden to Ukraine. He wants the enemies of Russia to be the enemies of the United States, and that is Ukraine and Democrats. That is what he's been working towards. If you noticed, in 2016, we had a lot of dash cam leaks and a lot of protests as well. The one for Oxford was for the trans ban. They tried to contact me about it. I had been told about it in 2014, and it is nefarious. And they had a lot of... She was talking to WikiLeaks online, and they were telling her information. Like, I had a missionary uncle overseas who had worked for the CIA, and my uncle had just fled Venezuela being accused of capitalist propaganda. They have a lot of information. They knew, you know, that target policy I didn't know about, but it was coming up 2 years later, and they even knew the city council would ban. It's incredibly, you know, it's complicated, but it's at the same time, it's not. Trump is a traitor. The fake news, deep state rhetoric is what all dictators use. It's exactly what the asset I was talking to in 2014 was saying, and it's Trump's exact beliefs. And he leans on them. Like, I hear the FBI all the time talking like, oh, it might be just because he's so mentally ill and narcissistic that he just can't cope with it. But that's a lie. He was building Trump Tower in Moscow throughout the election. Trump is a traitor. If you don't wake up to the fact, then when he tries to call our election fake, you know, you're not going to be ready for what comes next. Because we cannot let his secret police and trash cult take any ground.